Hello, my name is Cody and I'm with LaunchDarkly. And in this LaunchDarkly at Lightspeed video, we're going to explore the nebulous world of CICD and the concept of release. This is a space that is heavily debated and there's a lot of content out there talking about what these concepts are. And we're hoping to give you a little bit of an understanding of how we fit into that space and how you can release software faster with less problems. If you've worked in the DevOps space much, you've seen a chart like this before where it starts to break down the idea of continuous integration and continuous delivery. This is the CICD process, and really it's the things that go into building and deploying software onto something. So on the continuous integration side, this is all about what do we do with the code, right? Somebody's developed it. Is it stored in a Git repository somewhere? What's the version control strategy look like? How is that code base branched out into multiple branches that can be developed off of? Or is it developed all in one trunk, just the main version of that, that code base? From there, how is it actually built? How is it turned into packages and artifacts that can be used by the delivery steps to actually put this somewhere? Code testing goes into that, right? How are we making sure that when this goes to get deployed, it's not going to blow up, or that all of our potential problem areas are covered via testing? There's a lot more that can go into continuous integration, but that's kind of the broad strokes of the CI portion of this. Switching over to the CD part, this is how do we take those things that have been produced in the CI steps and place them somewhere. A lot of times what environment this lands on is part of the CD process. And it's really that idea of taking it and putting it somewhere, right? So if that's a Kubernetes cluster or a server sitting somewhere, it's ultimately that mobility aspect of the thing that's been produced. There's also post-deployment verification that comes into this. How are we verifying that the thing that was deployed is actually going to come up successfully or has come up successfully? Again, there's a lot more that can go into the CD space, and this is a space that's growing quickly. So this will continue to change and continue to mature. We see these two steps oftentimes building off of each other. People build software, push it into a repo, the CI process takes it, builds that code, and then deploys it onto a thing. These are largely infrastructure concerns, even though they're working with software. It's the taking of that software version of the code and dropping it onto infrastructure somewhere. At LaunchDarkly, we see there being an additional step that comes into play here. And ultimately, it's the place that we underpin. It's this idea of feature release. And it's this concept that you can oftentimes build software and deploy it onto a thing, but ultimately want to control how those features are released to the people who use that software. You don't want to take 10 features that have been developed and release them to everybody at the same time. What if there's a problem in there somewhere? What if you want to test specific capabilities of those features first? Feature release allows us to break apart that idea of the infrastructure deployment from the consumption of software. And we break this apart by using things like targeting rules to influence what users are actually receiving that. We can do this via things like progressive delivery, the idea of gradually rolling out these changes to your user community. We can say 10% of your users receive this change, or we can say 50% of your dev users receive this change if we want to get more fancy and use something called a segment to control what users are receiving that. We can also target different identities of a user. So we could say browser-based users or mobile device-based users. We have a fully customizable targeting system that allows you to control what users you ultimately release a feature to, because that's what's really important here, is the idea of controlling who's actually experiencing the changes that you're putting into your application. If there's a problem, you want a way to immediately back that out, and we consider that part of the release step, the idea of having a quick kill switch in place that doesn't require you to go through that entire CD process again to redeploy an old version of the software. We can simply toggle that feature off, remove it from the code so that it's no longer being consumed by the users, or change the targeting rule so that no users are receiving it anymore, and move back into that integration step. And that's why in this diagram, the arrows move into a circle all the way through feature release, because release is something that ultimately impacts CI as well as CD. In the modern software world, we see this idea of feature release as being a core component of the way that we're building and shipping software. The idea of CD is taking that software and placing it onto infrastructure, but feature release is making the capabilities available to the users who consume them. The idea of release being a separate concept from CI/CD is because ultimately release focuses on the way that your users are consuming the software you've built. You want to be able to control the amount of features that you put in front of a group of users so you can make sure the experience is everything you wanted it to be. Release allows you to gradually roll out those changes to groups of users that you configure. And when there's a problem and something goes wrong, you can ultimately toggle that feature off via kill switch and feed back into the continuous integration step, rebuild it, hand off to continuous delivery to have it deploy out somewhere again, and continue iterating on that feature through the release process. I hope this video has helped you understand a little bit more about the CICD space and where LaunchDarkly fits in. If you have any more questions about it, we'd love to hear from you. Looking forward to talking to you soon. Take care.